Hi, this is rickysun. I'm a Pi consultant. In this video, I'm going to talk about Azure Data Factory and how it relates to what we do as a Pi administrator. Azure Data Factory, it is a software as a service in Microsoft Azure. Maybe you can think, if you are in oil and gas, you can think of unprocessed oil, go to a refinery, which is Azure Data Factory, right? Similar. And then after processing the oil, it goes out, become a gasoline product, which you can sell to the market, right? So this is what kind of like similar analogy. So Azure Data Factory, data coming in the format you want as an input, and then it can output to a database, to a data lake, or to a file. Input and then output after processing in the middle. The middle is the Azure Data Factory. So in the factory, how is it related to the Pi system? We have a trouble, always have air crashes because tables is not available from the source. We also have problems of calculation. Lagging time is like a minute for some calculations because the table from the source is slow. Those are the problems we have faced. We got laggy calculation because we are using table lookup and the tables is crap. What do we do? Like we throughout my year with, I don't know, OSI soft, we suggest customer, hey, you know, create more tags using Pi RDBMS interface. Put the data into Pi tags, then the performance will increase, right? But the problem is you have to buy more tags, right? We're not, my customer is always not EA customer, which is like smaller company. So we want to limit ourselves to use Pi tags. So this is not an option for us because, you know, when you can use table lookup and then look at the table, get the data into Pi and even perform calculation. Why create more tags for the same thing? We have to think another way to think, I don't know, people say out of the box. Actually, this is not came out from me, but this is came out from my client. My client, his company have a team of Azure portal. They show things like fancy stuff and Power BI, right? They are cloud engineer. They are like the data engineer. And then they show us like Azure Data Factory. After they show us Azure Data Factory and we understand it, the technique become ours. What we do is we think, okay, we have this problem, slow and lagging AF crashes. How about we bring in the data to the Azure Data Factory, process that, then output it to another table that is like really flat, only have three columns, like, I don't know, tag name, value, and timestamp. Flat table within the size of recommended. So we grab only the necessary data from Azure Data Factory and then filter it to become another table. In AF, originally we use table lookup to original table, which can crash, which is less CPU, RAM is less and slow, right? Now we use Azure Data Factory to look at that. And then when it output, it dump the data to another table, which is inside Azure. Like we can use Azure database, we can use Azure SQL database, or we can even put it into back into where we have SQL server as well, or we can do any format, by the way, but in our case we want to put it back into a table so we can use AF to look up that table, like unprocessed the table, and then there's a processed table, and we want AF to look at the processed table, not the unprocessed table, right? Is that clear? So after you do that, data is always available here, even this is crashing, right? Let's say, because it's entirely different animal, right? Reduce the, all the crashes, increase the performance because the table is so flat, right? Only the data you need, and then only the column and data you need in the query, right? If the query become like select from where, like statement, super simple statement. Of course, you have to do some integration to modify your table lookup, but you do that from the template, so you don't have a lot of to do, right? You just modify the query in the table lookup and for the table as well.
Maybe there is a cost of Azure Data Factory because it's based on the compute time, but consider the cost of crashing AF and people doesn't have their abnormally detecting. I think it's worth using the money to integrate this unit inside your pisystem. Although this is not part of the pisystem, but I would say this is very important, right? And I don't know if you have already using it or now you're thinking about it. I strongly recommend you integrate Azure Data Factory into your pisystem if you are using table lookup, so that performance increase, of course, but it could prevent your AF crashes, increase the analytic to run faster as well. So it can recalculate faster, can run the calculation faster instead of having lagging. Lagging is coming from like, it perform the calculation, it take everything into memory, right? If your table lookup is slow, and that's the gap is, right? You shorten the gap, then your performance is going to increase. That's all I wanted to share. And today, my voice is not the greatest, but thank you for watching. I'll see you next week. Please don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon. I'll see you next week. Bye.